Okay, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to be showing how to create an autoblog, which just gets content from others. So I have two sites here. Both of mine, as you can see, are mine. Now, this one is Techros and this is Sabayla's Academy. So, what we're going to need is a couple of things, very most of which are free. They're all free anyway. Now we're going to use a plugin and an extension to get the data we need. So what we're going to do is, first of all, come over here. I just want to show you the sites first. This is the post it has. So it's about five. I'm just getting just a few of them here. The next one is over here, and it has lots of content. So I want to create an auto blog with this one, although it's a free hosting, and this one is the paid hosting. But I want to create an auto blog that will get content from this automatically without me lifting a finger once I set it up. So this is what I'm going to do. Come to my dashboard. I need to install a plugin. I've already installed it for the sake of time, and I don't like the way the audio is going, so I just want to get this over as quickly as possible I can. This part, this is the plugin I'm going to be using. It's called Sabayla SEO Lite. Then another thing you're going to need, first of all, is this extension. It's called Get RSS Feed URL. What this does is, when you ever go, you go to a site you want to get their content from. By the way, I'm using my site, so copyright laws may apply, but this is mine. So what I'm going to do is this, just, it's for educational purposes. So it's going to check and try to get my site's feed link, as you can see. Automatically copy. Now why you should use this plugin is because it's going to help you, this extension is going to help you differentiate between, you're going to get the feed link for you, but it's going to be easier for you to just get the exact link, whether it's Blogger or WordPress you're using, on the other one. So you're just going to get the feed link alone out. So for example, now that I'm using Blogger and WordPress here, if I'm not using WordPress, I can't use this slash feed, it won't work. For example, if I'm using Blogspot, let me show you Blogspot. What is also mine? All these sites are mine, so let me show you something. And this is on Blogspot. Right. So when I click here now, you're going to see this is the difference. I won't be able to know exactly this unless I have clicked on this link. I can copy from here too. So if I want to copy from here or from here down, I just need to click on this one here, this extension, and to get me the link and copy it. So since I'm already done here, what I do now is this. I'm going to show you the default configuration that you should use. You should use for this plugin, which is going to be best for you. So what I'm going to say is alter default settings. But this is the first time I'm using it on this site. Here you can rename the. This is like the default place you're going to send your your post to, the category you're going to put them in. Since I've not named it, is by default called uncategorized on WordPress. I can select this or I decide to leave it. Now if I decide to leave it, what I'm going to do is tell this part here to create a new category, at least defined the syndicating post, meaning the same way it is in the other site, the category should be the same category here. But if I was selecting this, it means put it in this category. If I select both of them like this, it means put it in this category and also make it a post belonging to another category. margin the same way it is on the other side. I know if you're getting what I'm saying, I mean, I'm watching too much, but just try to get it. And anything you need to know, ask a question in the comment section and I will be glad to clarify. So this is it. Now let me use this part instead. See, do this. The third option you have there is do not syndicate the post that doesn't match at least one category defined above. This is when you define the categories there. If you don't define the categories, never mind, just leave it at this. Create new categories, define it, syndicating posts. So this part here means try to extract the full article. Some sites will give you a snippet or what you call an excerpt. So this part will say go ahead, try and get the full post for me. Okay, so this part here is saying which author do you want it to go to. By default this is it, so I'm going to leave it like this. Now create tags from category names. If you want to also create tags automatically, you can also do this. Click here, create tags automatically. The only reason I would not want you to do this is when your site is being crawled by Google, it might end up crawling too many tags, which is not really a bad thing, but it might give it less important things to crawl. But if you have mainly just posts for it to crawl, it will focus on crawling the posts rather than crawling so many tags, and it will be showing you that index more things on your site, but it's just tags. So if you don't want multiple tags, you can interest is just not really a bad thing, but I prefer it to be this way. You can leave the site blank. If you always want to specify a particular tag you want to add to it, maybe you want to maybe tech pros. Maybe I want to say tech pros. So it will automatically give you the tag as tech pros. But that's up to you again. Now here is going to check for duplicate posts, whether these posts have already been posted before or they're not. Okay, so you're going to use two checks. There's GUID and there is title. If you say GUID alone, it might give you duplicate posts. If you say title alone, it might give you a duplicate post too. So you prefer to use this two. Now the next thing is how long will it stay before it gets another it's going to get another post. So here you can set 0 if you don't want it to go automatically, but we want to set for an auto blog, so we leave the minutes in. This 100,440 minutes means it's going to be for one full day before it tries to get another post from that blog. Here is the maximum number of posts you can get from that feed. So because I'm using a free hosting to demonstrate this one, I'm going to just leave it at 1 for now. If you're doing a shared hosting or you have a premium plan, you can set it to a higher number, but the more you increase this number, the more load is going to be on your resources, on your web hosting resources, and that might make your site unresponsive for a while. It might give you a 503 error. So you can keep it minimum. If you want to get regularly, you can keep this part, say 5. I'm not going to do that for this, but in the shared hosting, I don't want the site to go down for maxing out resources. And you can say maybe this is every 3 hours, 180. Mm-hmm. So let's make this 2. I don't want to over stretch it. And let's make this 240. So every 4 hours you're going to get 2 posts maximum. So what is it going to do when it gets the post? Should it publish it, hold it for review, save as draft, save as private, whatever it is, but I prefer to just say publish. So I don't need to come there. Imagine I'm not around to do work on my blog and I keep it for review or something like that, or draft. I'm going to have a lot of drafts to publish later. So I love to just publish. You can still update the post. Now the comments, do you want the comments to be enabled on the post you syndicate? and in the post you grab from other sites. Allow, yes, allow people to comment. If you don't want, you can disable comments on the, those posts. Pings, allow pings, accept. Now this part here, there are two things. If you get from post, if the post is, maybe today is January 4th and 2024, and the post was posted in December 4th 2023, it's going to post it or publish it as though it was unsent to that date, December. So you're going to have the posts falling in line the same way it is on the other site. But if you don't want it to be that way, you can say use syndication date. It means it will use the current time. So this is January 4th. Even the post was posted in December 31st, it will show on my blog when it's posted as January 4th. Now this part you can leave and do not insert attachments. This is because if you try to insert attachments, it might give you extra images that you don't need. Since the images are already going to be in the post, if you tend to attach at the top, you might see the featured image and you see it again and again on the site, which is not what I want. So I don't want to get any image, I just have to leave it this way. It's not insert. Now, how does it get it? There are different this is your thumbnail, which is your featured image of the post. So what you're going to do is tell it to get it from the first place. You can also tell it from media attachments thumbnail, but first image in the post. This is because most times that's the best image you can get from it. And if you try to use the thumbnail from the post itself, it might be low quality and you might end up having a blurry image. So let's leave it at the first post. The next one you're going to see is post thumbnail is quite, yes, very very much so. Now if you are seeing this, if I go down here, this was I just published because I wanted it to get this part. Now there are no images in this post. There are no images here. Now the problem is if it goes on like this, so you see there are no images here, and it's not very nice for you to have a blog that doesn't have images. It's not very attractive. So if you crawl and you don't get out the images, you might have to start going back to edit and put in images. So what it does is post thumbnail is required. If the plugin cannot create a thumbnail for the post, it won't get the post on your blog. If it gets it, to delete it automatically. There's no post thumbnail. After converting, enable now store images locally. Store images locally. Now there are two parts. This, if you enable it, it will save the images locally for you, but this might also increase your what's it called? Your nodes, the number of nodes you have in your system, in your storage, your web allocation. So some of them, like I think they are about 30,000, will give up to 30,000 or more, depending on what you paid for. So if you store it locally, it's going to be increasing that. But it's also going to help you load faster when you're trying to get, when your page is loading. So you can still keep it as this. You can always clear images later or reduce the number of images you have in your system with several plugins. Like a cleanup. But just in case, this, if you save it on your own site, you're going to have a faster loading page because it's loading from your own site. But if it's loading from another site, when the page loads and it's trying to get that image, you have to contact the other site and then try to pull it over here. Now the problem with that is if they're having a hot link protection, the images might not be allowed to load on your own site, and depending on the speed of the other site too, or how to respond, you might have that issue. So let's just move ahead, leave it that way. Now, what do you want to put in the HTML? Don't touch these ones, but this part now, you can put the HTML code, maybe it's an ad or something. How I put it, you want to add something like maybe a link to your post. Just anything you want to add in HTML, you can even put an ad code inside there. So automatically any of those posts that's indicated will automatically have an ad within them, or to be at the footer of the post, as close to the bottom of the post, like at the end of the post. So this is for this. If you want to, if you add something like this, for example, let's say this, I copy it and put over here, let's say I paste it in here, it's going to get the link from the original post and add it as a source. To add it as a link on that says source. The next thing I'm going to say is insert post footer into excerpts, not necessary. Shorten this, not necessary. Embed videos, yes. Because if I'm getting a post, or maybe the post has a YouTube tutorial or something inside, I need to also show that tutorial. For example, the post might say, watch this video below. And if I don't tell it to embed the video, I'm going to have a post that says watch this video below, but I'm not going to have any video for anybody to watch in it. So it is very, very important. I need to do that. Now, if you have any of these, what they call it, translate, maybe the language you're using is not English, maybe, for example, and you want to, let's say you are getting a content that is Hindi and you want it to be English. They really don't have English here. But let's say you're translating from one language to another. You can use this, but we're not using it. You're not translating because everything you're getting is English. And we don't have the API key for that now. So we can just say update settings. Now this will have the default. This will save as the default settings. Now remember, I copied my link. If I go back here and show you, click here, remember the plugin and the extension, sorry, and I copy this and I come back over here and paste until I try to syndicate. This is why I don't like free hosting. This is why I don't like it. It's always going to be an error and this, that, and that. But let me just keep that in mind and open this other site for you. Just still mine. I just want to demonstrate that part for you. Now, I hope you understand all I have done so far. If you don't, please ask a question in the comments. I just want to show you how it's going to work. But it's because I'm using free hosting and some of those that the PHP is not working with it and I can't change it, or it's just one of those issues. But on your premium plans, your paid plans, it will work. So I have to paste it in here and say syndicate. As you can see, this is the first post you got there, and this post is actually empty. That's why you're seeing it this way. If you come back here, I just mistakenly published that as from my draft. If you come back there, you see that it's empty. That's why I'm showing you this. My feeds are allowed to be full, and everything is already set here. All I have to do is just say syndicate. Now, I want this to show immediately I get it. So let me adjust it to use syndication date. So if it gets any post from me, it's going to show up as the latest post automatically. So this is it. Now it's going to wait a while and try to get it, but I want to pull it now. If you want to make it work now, immediately say, you click on it and say pull selected feed now. It's going to try to, are you seeing that there's no error on this one? But if it was a free one, to show me errors, because some of the resources I need are limited. It'll take a while sometimes to search through the feeds and get something tangible for you. But let's keep reloading the page and see what comes up. And this is another issue you're going to get. If you, I think I set up to 10. Now if you have multiple tags like that, if you have a high level, high amount of posts you're going to get, you may not respond, your site may not respond immediately, because it's busy trying to get the post from the other site back to you, to your site. So what we're going to do is wait a little and see if it responds, and we know that it's going to, we'll see the post. So I'm going to pause this video and then we'll come back to it.